Today's tutorial
is how to do demon eyes
in DaVinci Resolve. Before it gets too dark though, you can also use this same effect to do like zombie eyes or like dragon eyes, all sorts of different solid color eyes. Let's get into how to do this technique. Alright, so here we are inside of DaVinci Resolve. We've got our clip in the timeline that we're going to be editing for this effect. If you can, if you're like filming with an actor or a talent, try to have it so that during the scenes that they are going to have this effect being applied to them, that they don't blink as much as they normally would, because it's pretty hard to get the blinks in there, and it sells the effect better if they don't blink. You just have that solid eye, and it gives it a little bit of less of a human element if they're just open eyes. So that being said, let's jump into Fusion and we'll get started. So we've got our media in and our media out as per usual. What we're going to start with are two backgrounds. We're going to take them away from this merge. And what I just did there is I highlighted both of them so I could drag both, and I held shift while pulling them away to break its connection. And then I'm going to grab this merge, and while I'm holding it, I'm going to press shift again and hold it and drop that right into this line. And then just to make sure it's in the line, we're going to wiggle this around, because if you just set it on there and you miss with your shift click, you won't see any of these effects. So if you can go like this and it doesn't follow, you definitely need to make sure that it's a part of that line. So we're going to have our eye color as background 1 and our eye reflection as background 2. If you want to rename them, the hotkey to do that is F2, but I'm going to leave them how they are for the time being, because we're going to be working one eye at a time. So we're going to take this first background here and we're going to match it. Since we're doing the demon eye effect, they're generally going to be black for this. So we're going to grab a natural black color. We're not just going to go solid black, because that tends to look weird in a video. So we're going to grab something black in the frame. So in this case, you could use the pupil, you could use the headphone. You're going to want to use some sort of natural black color. So I'm just going to grab the pupil here, and then without connecting this to anything yet, we're going to grab our spline tool here, which is going to automatically keep those curves going, so you're not going to have to do a million points around your eye. We're going to start in the corner, we're going to go up, and then we're just going to mask off the eye like this. Boop. And make sure those all line up so that we're getting the whole eye. Looks good to me. Now that we have that, we can go ahead and check. Boom, there it is, blacked out. And then for our background, we're going to do the same thing, but we're going to grab our eye reflection here. And then we're going to grab, boop. So that's black too right now. We're going to go ahead and change that to the actual color of the reflection. So if we grab our background, grab our eyedropper over here, drag it out, and we're going to grab the color of that reflection. So now if we go ahead and put that there, should be solid. All right, looks good. So then we're going to merge these two together so that we have our color and our reflection in one point. So we're going to get these out of the way a little bit, get our merge. The next step here is very important. So we're going to hit shift spacebar to pull up our menu. And then once this is up, we're going to type in planar tracker. Now we have this. We need to put this in the line, same way we did with our merge. Check to make sure it's in there, otherwise it won't work. We're going to zoom out by holding control and scrolling. And then we're going to go ahead and change this to hybrid point area and change perspective to translation, rotation, and scale. I generally have better results with that. We are going to go ahead and grab our planar tracker, and we're going to select a space for this to track. I like to get a pretty big selection because DaVinci is pretty efficient about the way they do it. We're going to go ahead and track this forward. So you'll probably have this issue too if you're not starting from the very beginning. See, we're on frame 658 here. So we're going to want to go up to reference time, set, and then we're going to track forward. So now that all of that is tracked, we're going to go back to our first frame, which in this case is 658. We're going to go ahead and create a planar transform with this button inside of the planar tracker. And then we're going to run this merge into the planar transform here. And then we're going to drag this into the merge that we put into our node flow earlier. And then you'll see, boop, once that loads up, we've got a black eye. It does still look a little bit weird though. It looks harsh. So what we're gonna do is grab our first spline for the black part of the eye, hold control and drag out this soft edge here. It's a little easier to see if you double click in here, and this tool should stay up when you do that. So we're gonna go ahead and drag that out, and then that's gonna take a minute to load as well, so we're just gonna call that good right there. And then we're gonna wanna do the same thing to the reflection. We're gonna drag out that soft edge, and then we're gonna wait for that to load up. It's generally going to take a little bit longer to load through this planar transform, so if we just go ahead and take that out of there, we can make changes to our masks just like this, right directly through that merge. So we can see that we need to move that up a little bit and maybe these points out so it covers more of the eye with that soft edge. So then we're gonna close this off. We're gonna get a brand new planar transform. We're going to link this into it, and then we're gonna link it to the merge, and we'll see, there it is. There's our adjusted mask, and then we're gonna go ahead and move forward, and it should move with your eye. If you find any weirdness, like right here, we can see it's separating a little bit, go back just a few frames, make a keyframe for that. So we're gonna just move one of the points just a little bit so that it automatically keyframes. And then we're gonna go forward to where we lose that eye, which we'll call right there. And then we're gonna grab it, and we're gonna go ahead and just stretch those out a little bit. This looks weird because my computer is struggling with this effect, but it should all line up. And then when you go back and then forward again, you'll see that it grabs that part of the eye and it's staying with that because we're running it through this planar transform. So you go forward until you lose part of it, and then you go back a few frames, and then you're going to want to just adjust that spline and then forward to where you lose that eye, and then you're going to bring that out. And then you keep on going. We're losing a little bit of the bottom there, so we go back to where we have it. We're gonna make a slight keyframe. So you can click and drag multiple spline points here, but if that's not precise enough for you, you can go ahead and control click. So hold control and then click on the points that you wanna change, and then you can drag them as a group. So we will go ahead and keep on moving forward here. Looks like my eye starts to close there. So we're gonna go ahead and grab the spline. I'm gonna grab these top bits there and close the eye. So once we've gone through and fixed all of our splines so that they match up to our eye, we should see right there that it pretty well sticks with our eye. You can see that there's a little bit there at the end where it gets jittery, right around that area. So we're gonna have to click on our spline and get in there and figure out why. Where it's full, and then it's not, and then it's full again. So we're gonna need to make sure that this part is up with the rest of that. So you can see that it looks a little bit wonky and a little in a couple spots, but if you're careful with your spline and you go through and you adjust it where it needs to be adjusted, you'll find that you've got the effect working in very little time and it doesn't take too much effort. This is what your node web should look like. And then once you have that done for this eye, we are going to go ahead and group all of these together by dragging across them with a box. And then we're gonna go ahead and control G. Now we're gonna get into renaming something. So group one here, we're gonna rename to right eye. And now we have right eye. And if we disconnect that, boom, no more right eye. Connect it again, right eye is good to go. So if we go back out into our edit window, once this red bar turns blue, we'll play through it and you'll see that it plays just how you'd want it to. You can see there, moves, back, forward, and it sticks with the eye. That's all there is to doing the demon eye effect. If you want to get like a zombie eye effect or a dragon eye effect, like I said in the intro, you can go ahead and grab this background color and just change it. So with a zombie, you're gonna go for more of like a gray, maybe a little bit of transparency, so you can still kind of see the eye in there, but ultimately what you're going to do is that. Or if you wanted to get a little bit creative, you could get rid of this background and put in a photo, clouds, or like maybe galaxy eyes if you want to get a little extreme. Really, the only thing that limits what goes in here is your imagination. So in order to do this next eye, you literally just take what you did for this one and you get a new track. You can't use the same track, so we'll just set that off to the side. And we'll go ahead and shift spacebar. You should still have planar tracker selected because you looked for it earlier. Then you're going to hit add. You're going to grab your second one. You're going to shift and put it right in that line. Make sure it's connected just like we did before. Then we're going to come up to point, change that to hybrid point area and perspective, change that to translation rotation scale just like we did before. And then we're going to grab a big chunk of things that move as a group. And then we're going to go to our first frame here. We are going to hit set so that we get our correct reference time. And we're going to track forward to the end of the clip. All of these little dots in here just show where it's tracking. So the more of those you have, the more accurate your track will be. So then you're gonna go ahead and, the same as before, make your two backgrounds, take this merge, move it down here, take this out of the line, and move that over there, background, background. This background, we're gonna use the darker black color. We're gonna go with the pupil again. And then for this, we're gonna zoom in on the eye. We're gonna grab that reflection. And then we're going to just spline it off, just like we did before. This one's going to be real rough and fast. So we'll get this, we'll grab a spline for this one as well. Just close that up. And then we take these and we merge them, the merge node there. You definitely want the big color to be the background, so the yellow line, and the small reflection to be the green line. If they aren't, just click on your merge, Control T, and you'll swap them. So then we have this. If we pop this down here, you'll see we've got our thing going on. Everything's how it should be, but we're going to need to soft edge these just like we did before. And whoop, good to go, just like that. And then we're going to drop a planar transform into that path. We're gonna need that. Drag our merge through it. Get that right in there. Oh, all right. So here we see an issue that doesn't always happen, but sometimes will. So what we're gonna do with this is click on our merge, the one that we used between here and the planar transform. And we're gonna click it. And then we're gonna click on this transform node button right here. Then we're gonna grab the middle of this transform and we're just gonna move that right back onto our eye. No problem. Boom. And then it's back in the eye. We're going to move forward. Oop, we were at the end. Shoot. Now that we're at the beginning of the clip, we're going to hit that transform. We're going to rotate it on over. And then it looks like we're going to need to move it up a little bit and to the side. And then if we move through our clip, it should stick right with that eye. You can see there are a couple points in there where we're going to need to go in and adjust the spline points, but for the most part, that's looking pretty good. So that wraps it up on how to do the demon eye effect in DaVinci Resolve. I hope you guys learned a lot from this video. If you did, please let me know in the comments down below. If there was anything that I didn't clearly communicate to you guys, please let me know that down below. That pretty well wraps it up. So I will see you guys next Thursday at 6 a.m. sharp, or whenever you choose to watch the video. Until then, have a good week, and I'll see you in the next one.